Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to x86 assembly course. So this is video number 26. In this video, we will see local variables and argument passing. As I have done in a previous videos, I have created a new project and set some project properties. You will find how to set a project properties video in the I button above. This is a C program. First, we are including stdio.h file. After that, we will start the execution from main. Main is defining integer a equals 1. Second variable in integer b equals 2. Then main is calling function and passing two arguments a and b. Then we are in function defining two parameters, integer arg1 and integer arg2. After that, function saving arg1 into the x and arg2 into the y. After that, function defining new variable var1 equals 3, second variable var2 equals 4, and the function is returning with the var2. We will return to the main and return value passed by a function. We will save that into the new integer known as the integer value. After that, main is returning with the ones and main is ending here. Let's build the program. Click on build solution. As we can see, build is succeeded. Now let's see what happened when we click on build. Just imagine we have a source code file example.c. C preprocessor will create a preprocessed code file from the example.c file, and example.i file will be generated. After that, C compiler will convert that file into the assembly code file, and example.s file will be generated. Then assembler will convert that file into the object code file, and example.o file will be generated. And linker, with the help of other object code file and object code libraries, will convert that file into the example.exe file, and executable file will generate it. When we click on the build, this all process has happened in the background, and end result will be an executable file. Now let's debug the program, but before that, we'll set our breakpoint here. Then click on debug. Okay, now let's see what happens when we click on debug. Now with the help of a build, we got our executable file example.exe. That file is currently stored in a secondary storage, and when we execute that file, operating system will assign loader to do further operations. Then loader, with the help of a runtime objects modification libraries, will assign that executable file process address space into the primary memory. Now the things which we saw earlier, such as moving data between the register, setting a new function stack frame onto the stack, calling another function, returning from another function, these all are performed by the loader. That's it for this video. In the next video, we will execute our C program and we will see the modification of stack and changes in registers when we pass arguments to another function and a function has a local variables. So stay tuned. Thank you.